2-0, fellas. 2-0. That's all that matters. Hey, that's a quality team. I think everybody knows that. All right. How about that defense?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. They got playmakers. That quarterback can flat get after. Holding those guys at 6 points, unbelievable. Offense, we're able to run the football in the second half. That was a big key. And then we covered kicks, all right, and our extra point field goals did a good job with that. So, fellas, 2-0. Couldn't be happier. I want you to enjoy this. All right, the super job of playing for each other and playing for Auburn. All right, where's Coach Steele? Come up here and lead us the fight song.
I mean, it was great, man. I mean, all white out, man, just having the fans back. He enjoyed it, man. It was amazing, man. We appreciate our fans no matter what, man. And we just appreciate them for being here, even though it was Tulane, man. It was just a great game.
It's awesome. I love Jordan Hare. They got the best fans in the country, best fans in the country, best student section in the country. Just this place is amazing. I love it.
Yeah, man. It feel like home. You know, AKA I call it the crib because I'm from Florida. So, man, just feel like home. I appreciate the fans. You know, I appreciate everybody coming out supporting us.
Yeah, man. I mean, that was a good performance, man. I feel like it could have been better. Now we got a lot of things we got to clean up in the fan room, and I mean, you know, come out here, we'll be better next week.
I thought it was a good interception. You know, D-line made a good pressure to the quarterback, kind of threw it up in the air. You know, I ran up on it and made a play.
It was awesome. Design play, the safety rolled out to the other side, so the middle was wide open. I gave Bo a hard time because he threw it low, but luckily I caught it, did a little spin move, and got in the end zone. So just thankful for the opportunity.
The Auburn Football Review, featuring Coach Ralph Shub Jordan.
Be sharp, be ready. Tonight's what our program's all about.
I'm proud of every one of you.
This team has the it factor.
The official Auburn post-game show since 1954. This is the Auburn Football Review with head coach Gus Malzahn, presented by Toyota.
Welcome to the Auburn Football Review presented by Toyota. I'm Andy Bertram along with Auburn head coach Gus Malzahn. 2-0 on the season, coach.
Yeah, 2-0. That's the number one stat there. Real proud of our team. First home game, man, the fans were unbelievable. Really appreciate them coming out in the heat. It was hot out there. But at the end of the day, we're 2-0 and real proud of our team.
Talked about wanting to run the football in the second half, and you did just that.
Yeah, that's the key. When we're able to run the football effectively, we're a real solid offense. You know, we had some troubles in that first half. We asked our quarterback to throw it 20-plus times. We've got to do a better job in the first half.
Let's take a look at the first half highlights.
Glover approaches it. We're underway. Kicks it into the end zone. Igbenogany, maybe a yard deep in the end zone, takes a knee to the Auburn sideline, and Nix rolls to his right, throws to Stove, who has it at the 30. He gets about to the 32-yard line. Play action, he rolls left. McMillan looks and he throws, and it's almost intercepted. Hastings in motion to the Tulane sideline. Out of the gun, Nix drops back, flushed, and throws it for Hastings. He turns and makes the catch just shy of midfield. First down, Auburn. Christian Montano with the snap. McMillan with time. He throws, and it is incomplete. Dual receivers right and left on third and 15 for the Green Wave. They hand off to Bradwell, and he's going to lose a couple yards on the play. Conservative? Absolutely. Marlon Davidson, Nick Coe for Auburn there. Nick's now under center. Sends Schwartz in motion. Fake handoff to Schwartz. Nick's deep drop. He wants to throw the screen to Whitlow with room to run. He's across midfield down the left sideline. Down across the 35-yard line near the 30. It's a first down for Auburn. Hastings and Williams wide left. Nix, couple steps, drops, throws it down the middle. Hastings at the 5. Makes a man miss. Hastings to the end zone. Touchdown, Auburn. 31 yards. There it is, Cam Martin. Excuse me. 9, not 8. Nix, short drop, throws out into the flat. It's complete. Stove has it, shy of the first down to the Tulane boundary. Right and left, the two receivers. Nix, handoff to Cam Martin. Good, good. Surge by that Auburn offensive line. 5 yards on first down for Auburn. There's the snap. Nix drops back. He throws. He wants to get it to Williams. This Williams jumps. He's got it! And in motion, Knicks, hands, no. Will go off the right side. Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Eli Stowe! First and 10 for the Green Wave. McMillan under center, and down he goes. Again, out of the gun, second down, throws it to Hastings. Goes down to a knee. One man to the left, trips short right. Play action. McMillan in trouble in the backfield, gets around Big Camp Bryant, throws it away. Second and 10 from the three. Nick short drop, throws it to Hastings. Got it, first down for Auburn. Play clock down to one. Auburn gets the playoff. Nick's throws, and it is complete. Nick's drops, gets some pressure, throws sideline. It's complete. Out of bounds. Cam Martin out of the backfield.
Coach, a first half that they score on that opening drive. It takes a little while from an offensive standpoint to get going, but I thought all game long your defense was terrific.
Yeah, they really were. Of course, third downs, 2 of 15. I mean, that was really the story of the game. Just did a super job holding that bunch to 6 points. I mean, that just says it all. And they got the ball back for the offense, and defense, hats off to them.
Reminder, this is a team that scored 42 points in its opener last week and was very, very balanced in its running and its passing, and held them out of the end zone.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And of course, I think they scored 42 points really almost in the first half, you know. So a very explosive quarterback. You can see their playmakers they had at the receiver position too. But like I said, I think that was really the story of the game.
When we come back, Auburn establishes the run with the second half highlights when we return on the Auburn Football Review, presented by Toyota.
The Auburn Football Review is presented by Verizon, one family, many unlimited plans. And by Toyota. Let's go places.
Thanks, Dad.
Yeah, I was in the neighborhood.
Get 0% APR for 60 months plus 500 bonus cash on a new 2019 Camry. Toyota, let's go places. Just like your favorite mascot, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama works hard behind the scenes. Proud sponsor of the Tide and Tigers.
Five-star backyards, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have this yellow tag, you don't want it.
Hey, I'm Jamie Johnson. When we reach the age of 18, voting becomes our civic duty. But what if it was our job? We wouldn't be so quick to call in sick or go back home if the lines were too long, or just dismiss the idea altogether. Elections are also how we collectively write the song that tells our story, and voting is our solitary voice. So register to vote and go get your government-issued photo ID and add your voice to the song of Alabama.
Give the ball up and over and in, I believe.
Bo was a talent that gave us a chance.
The winner is, from Auburn University, Bo Jackson.
The 1982 Iron Bowl is viewed by many as the turning point for Auburn football.
I don't know whether I had already thought about it, but made me think about it. The pressure that he was putting on himself going back to Birmingham and playing against Alabama for the first time in 1982. And I told him, I said, Bo, I said, I can't even imagine, you know, what it's like to be in your shoes to represent what you represent here at Auburn. I said, but I can tell you what you mean to Auburn. I said, with you on our football team, we can go to Birmingham with hope.
The Tigers entered the fourth quarter trailing 14-22, but it wouldn't take long for them to respond. A 53-yard run by Bo set up a 23-yard Al Del Greco field goal, trimming the deficit to 5. The Auburn defense came up big when it was needed the most. The offense took over on the Auburn 34, and 4 minutes and 40 seconds later, the legend of Bo Jackson began.
Alabama game came down to 4th-and-1 on the 1, and Coach Dye called Bo over the top.
Nobody split. Give to Bo. Up and over. And in. I believe. Touchdown Auburn.
They knew what was coming. They had to know what was coming. And what they thought was coming did come. Bo over the top. And I remember standing on the sideline. And when he made that initial leap, I'm not sure he made it. But if you look at the film, I think you'll see second effort wiggling that body. Before he was stopped, he was clearly in the end zone. And one of the happiest days of my life, one of the happiest days of Auburn people's life, that stormed the field. But Bo had given Auburn hope when he signed, and he had carried them to the promised land, all in the space of about 18 inches.
You may know Auburn, but do you really know Auburn? We work hard, dream big, and soar past today's limits to the possibilities of tomorrow. Auburn, if you thought you knew us, think again. War Eagle.
Tiger Walk, often imitated, never duplicated. Where thousands come together. Their passion and pride uniting into one mighty roar. We are Auburn, and you are in for a fight. Ford has a tradition too, building the best-selling truck 42 years straight. It's the final days to get 20% estimated savings on select Ford F-150s, plus earn complimentary maintenance through Ford Pass Rewards.
At Verizon, we're building the most powerful 5G experience for America. That's why the NFL chose Verizon. Because they need the massive capacity of 5G with ultra-wideband, so more streaming, posting fans can experience 5G all at once. This is happening in 13 stadiums all across the country. Now Verizon 5G can do this for the NFL. Imagine what it can do for you.
Just like your favorite mascot, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama works hard behind the scenes. Proud sponsor of the Tide and Tigers.
Against Oregon, we'll see if the Tigers can do that after this defensive series, and Carlson out of the back of the end zone. Hand off to the tailback, trying to get outside, nothing doing there. Hand handoff to the tailback, and he is immediately taken down on the play. Second down and 9 for Auburn. Nix will carry this one. He has some room across the 10-yard line, angles to the sideline, gets to the corner, out of bounds at about the 18, and that's a first down for Auburn. McMillan rolls to the short side of the field, and he throws it. And it is almost intercepted. It is intercepted! He threw it over the head of Dauphine, and Jeremiah Dinson dove at the sideline and made the interception. Booby Whitlow off the right side, breaks a tackle. Whitlow carries a man inside Tulane territory. Second and 11 from the 48. The handoff to Whitlow. Goes left, gets close to the 40-yard line. A gain of about 7 on the play. Calls the play, steps back, sets. He throws, and it is complete to the tight end, and that's a first down for Auburn. From the 32, first down and 10 for Auburn. Nix the handoff. Booby Whitlow bounces it to the outside, gets upended, kind of helicopters his way down to around the 24-yard line. Whitlow looks to run around the right side. He's got some room. He's down to the 10. He's to the 5. And he's in for the touchdown, Auburn! Booby Whitlow, 14 yards out of the Wildcat. Phelps Gamble, the man in motion. Nix play action, sets up and he throws to the sideline. Canella's got it. That's enough for an Auburn first down. Bayak play action, now rolls right. Gets two men in front of him. Down the sideline. He's dives forward to the 10-yard line. Ledbetter to hold, Bill Taylor to snap it. The kick from Anders Carlson. Snap is down, Carlson puts it through, and Auburn has scored again. Nix floats it out. Caught out there, that's a first down down the left sideline to Matthew Hill. Hill from Lawrenceville, Georgia. Gatewood will run it off the left side, pulls forward. Gatewood gets into the clear. He's to the 36-yard line. And enough for an Auburn first down. Schwartz in motion. Gatewood, right side. Gatewood stays on his feet inside the 30, out of bounds at the 25, close to the 25, and that's an Auburn first down. Schwartz in motion. Gatewood will keep it himself. Joey Gatewood inside the 15-yard line. That's enough for an Auburn first down. And Gatewood just takes a knee after the Auburn timeout. And it appears that Tulane will not elect to call a timeout. The final seconds tick off the clock here. Tulane scored on its first drive of the ball game. Got a field goal at the end of the first half, but for the most part, Auburn dominant from a defensive standpoint tonight.
Coach, you mentioned that you wanted to run the football, establish the running game in the second half. You did that. What was the key?
Well, really we started getting some positive yards on first down. We mixed in the gap a little bit more. We were kind of zone heavy the first half, and I really think that helped to kind of gap them out a little bit. We were able to bounce, get some perimeter yards, and of course, you know, we scored on the Wildcat buck sweep when they were squeezing the ends right there. But really that was the big difference, that we were able to run a little more gap.
Booby Whitlow with another really good second half, relied on him, and boy, he paid off for you as well.
He did. He did a good job, some good hard runs. We got a hold on that football, though. You know, we got a hold on the football, and that was kind of uncharacteristic, putting the ball on the ground a couple times, and we'll do a better job of that in the future.
McMillan was 14 of 18 from the air a week ago in the win against Florida International. Tonight he goes 10 of 33 with an interception.
Yeah, and you know, he's very elusive too. You know, and I think our defense harassed him. I don't know how many times we got to him and sacked him, but we hit him a lot and really made him uncomfortable. And I think that really, you know, helped in that aspect.
Two straight weeks at home for the Tigers. We'll take a look at Auburn's next opponent, Kent State, when we return on the Auburn Football Review, presented by Toyota.
The Auburn Football Review is presented by Verizon, one family, many unlimited plans. And by Toyota. Let's go places.
You may know Auburn, but do you really know Auburn? We work hard, dream big, and soar past today's limits to the possibilities of tomorrow. Auburn, if you thought you knew us, think again. War Eagle.
Five-star backyards, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have this yellow tag, you don't want it.
Just like your favorite mascot, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama works hard behind the scenes. Proud sponsor of the Tide and Tigers. Playing college football on the big stage is all Jatarvius Whitlow wanted to do. Coming from a small town, he knew that he had to be the hardest worker around to achieve his dream.
I just always, like, growing up, I always told my mom that, like, I'm going to go to Auburn, like, because I like their style of play and I feel like I could fit it. Coming up, like, I just do things that, like, a lot of people just wouldn't do. I used to just grind and, like, fight because I knew for me to fulfill my dream, I had to be one of the best to do it. I just know once I took the field, you ain't going to stop me. Getting here and finally just reaching one of my goals in life and like accomplishing it, doing what I'm doing right now, like I just thank God, like, cause I went through a lot in high school and then came here, yeah, it's a blessing.
Once on campus, Whitlow had to wait for his turn. After redshirting his freshman season, he made his Auburn debut in 2018 and his presence was felt immediately. Whitlow was Auburn's leading rusher and named the SEC All-Freshman Team.
What I learned last year was, like, be more patient and, like, trust your linemen. Coming from 2A, I ain't really have a line like that. So I just really always knew to just run. So that was my biggest lesson from last year. And, like, I ain't really get into, like, all the talk about how I had or what I did. I just really, like, try to focus on me in past games and see what I can do better this year.
New for this year is his position coach. Auburn great Carnell Williams joined the coaching staff, and Whitlow is embracing the opportunity to learn from one of the best to don the orange and blue.
Having Coach Lat, man, it really a blessing. Just having one of the greatest players to coach us is awesome. Him just coming into this made us see a lot, and just a small thing, just a fix. And like he just helped out on that, and like it just changed the whole perspective of the game. So we all grew together more as brothers in the running back room. It's powerful having him.
Growing up only 30 minutes away from Auburn in Lafayette, Alabama, Whitlow's family are regulars during game days on the plains.
I love that, man. I love that. It like every Tiger walk, I see my mom in just to hug her right before I go on the field because I always thought like I'd never get to see her before the game. I just see her after. Just seeing them, like they there, and like they at every game, no matter where it at. Then here I can get more of my family to come, and they come see me. I really have the whole city down here. Like, the whole effect be down here, and like, it's just amazing just to be able to do something from a small town in a big league. Like, it just, the feeling is just like unexplainable. I can't even explain it.
Humbled by his journey, Jatarvius Whitlow defied the odds and is living proof that hard work
is the backbone of success.
Find it, start it, from anywhere with Remote Connect. Lease a new 2019 Toyota Camry LE for just $209 a month for 36 months. Toyota, let's go places.
Five-star backyards, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have this yellow tag, you don't want it.
You may know Auburn, but do you really know Auburn? We work hard, dream big, and soar past today's limits to the possibilities of tomorrow. Auburn, if you thought you knew us, think again. War Eagle.
At Verizon, we're building the most powerful 5G experience for America.
That's why the NFL chose Verizon.
Because they need the massive capacity of 5G with ultra-wideband, so more streaming posting fans can experience 5G all at once. This is happening in 13 stadiums all across the country. Now Verizon 5G can do this for the NFL. Imagine what it can do for you.
Wrapping things up on the Auburn Football Review presented by Toyota. All right. Second straight ball game at home. You get Kent State here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Very similar game time. Could have to deal with the heat as well, but you've been through it already once, right?
Yeah, we have. Our fans have too. But, I'm glad to be playing back at home this week. We'll need to correct some things from, this game tonight and, get our guys ready for game three.
What'd you see that you liked? What do you see that you want to improve upon?
Well, we got to cover kicks. I mean, you're going to continue to hear me say that. And I think at the end of the day, it's run the football. Run the football, and I really think we can be a good running team before it's all said and done.
Congratulations on this one, War Eagle.
All right, War Eagle.
Tigers head coach Gus Malzahn. I'm Andy Burcham. You've been watching the Auburn Football Review presented by Toyota.